So let me check how many of you will solve this then. Let me go and give this. Come on, get this answer right, all of you. I don't want anyone to make a mistake here. It's not necessary that you do all the time. Few fractions which you know directly, one is lesser, greater, keep them there. Which you are not sure, compare. Let me do it for the class. Now, so what I taught you just now before this particular question is how do we compare rational numbers? So the regular method that we learn at school is we make the denominators same and compare the numerators. Whichever is greater, that will be the greater fraction or greater rational number, right? But now there are numbers, questions like this. This particular question, if you observe, it doesn't require any calculation. There is some common sense and some numbers are known to us. For example, in this, the number like 3/4, I think everyone knows what is 3/4. 3/4 is 0.75, which is 75%, and 1/2 is 0.5. So one thing that we clearly know that 1/2 is less than 3/4, right? And now 1/2 is here. We know 3/4 will be more than that, which is here. I don't know. There might be other numbers coming in between. But I know for sure that 1/2 is on the left hand side, 3/4 is on the right hand side, because 3/4 is greater. Okay. Now the question is, so what about 7/9? So people who know 7/9, I think you know 7/9 as a fraction is 77.77%, if people know it. Even if you don't know, it's easy. Now you can quickly check between 7/9 and 3/4. You can easily check quickly. You can see 4 7s are 28, 8 9 3s are 27. You can see here. Can you quickly see that? Can I compare 7/9 and 3/4? Yes. 7 4s is 28, 9 3s is 27. So which is greater? 7/9. That means I know 3/4 and 7/9 will be somewhere here. Correct? But if you know 7/9, 7/9 is around 77.77%. Yes. Now the question is, there are two big numbers out there. Now, what are those big numbers? One big number that you can see is 2006/2007. Now, 2006/2007, if you observe this number, it tells you something very interesting. Can anyone tell me what does this talk about? 2006/2007? Quickly, anyone? Doesn't it ring some bells? Can I say 2006/2007? Now, can I say what is 2007/2007? It's 0.999. It will come like that. It's almost equal to 1. Now tell me, will that be more than 7/9 or will it be less than 7/9? More, of course, more. I need not calculate. The moment I see this number 2006/2007, I can say it will be more than this. So it should be 2006/2007. Now coming to the next number, 413/115. Now 415. When I look at this number, it also tells me something very clearly, very, very clearly. You can see 1/2. 1/2 is 50%. Can I say this is less than 50%? Because 413, 1000 ka aadha, 1000 ka. If I were to have 500 by 1000, 500 by 1000 is half. This numerator is less than 500, and this is more than 1000. Can I see that denominator? This numerator is less than the half of 1115. Can I say that is definitely less than half? Therefore, I can clearly say that should be here, 413 by 1115. What I'm trying to teach you, beta, everyone, look here. This is a very interesting question. If you solve by cross multiplying and all that, you're wasting a lot of time. Few questions are not given to you for solving. Few questions are given to you to test your ability to think fast. What is the ability here? You could quickly compare this versus this versus this. After this, they have given you two big numbers. How do you look at those numbers? One number is closer to one. That means it's more than 7 by 9. So, you know, when I look at this problem, the first thing that comes to my mind is 1 by 2, 7 by 9 coming in the middle. This cannot be my answer, right? 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 7 by 9. This looks fit. This also looks fit. This also looks fit. But now the question is, where is 2006 by 7? Now, if I can 2006 by 2007, it cannot be less than 1 by 2 because it's close to one. That means this number should move that side. So the option is, you know, it's here. Now the next is then this cannot be answered. You know, between this and this, how do you decide? You need to know where is this 413 by 115. You can see it's less than half. This is the only option. So that's the reason your D is the correct answer. So this question doesn't require you to actually solve anything.